Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. So let's begin our journey of current affairs with this video. But before that, if you are coming here for the first time, then do not forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell notification. And this is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to enjoy the free quizzes as well as the latest updates about the exams. This is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022. Here we provide you with PDFs, mocks and videos along with your mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your phase 3 of RBI Grade B, that is your final interviews. And this is the book kit that you will get if you enroll in our course, and that book kit includes all the books mentioned right in front of you. Right now we are running a 30% discount on this course, so if you want to avail that discount, you can use RBI 30 coupon code, and this is the number which you can use to call us if you have any query related to the examination. So here comes our first question. What is India's rank in Global Peace Index in 2020 and 2021? So here you can see many ranks given in front of you in the options. Out of these ranks, the right answer is option D. So in 2020, India's rank was 139, whereas it improved by 2 ranks in 2021. Now you would be amazed, or you would be thinking that I am telling you the wrong information, but right now this is not the wrong information, guys, because the improvement in the ranks is by 2 points only. But the reason behind the difference in the rankings is 4 points is because many countries have been given the same ranking. For example, if you take the example of Finland and Norway, for example, this is not the actual ranking. Just say that Finland and Norway have been placed at the 2 ranks. So the next country that would come after the Norway, that would be ranked at the 4th position. So that is why this difference is by 4 points. But in actual scenario, the rank has been improved by 2 points. So that is the difference. That is why this ranking is important for you to remember. Now let us understand what this Global Peace Index has in detail for us. So the first point here is the 15th edition of this Global Peace Index has been released, and it has been released by Institute for Economics and Peace, and this is a Sydney based organization. From here my question for you emerges that this organization releases a very important index as well, and you have to name the another index that this organization releases. Remember, it is again a very important index, and we have been covering those index that index for the competitive examination. So you have to name that index that which this organization releases. Now the total number of countries that were assessed in this index was 163. Iceland came at the first position. India's rank is 135th with a score of 2.553. Now guys, remember, this score is important for your exam point of view, because directly the score can also be asked from you. In 2020, India's rank was 139th, and India is a low peaceful country because of its ranking, 135th rank. Now what are the parameters? 23 indicators were divided into 3 categories of societal safety and security, ongoing domestic and international conflict, and degree of militarization. So these are the 3 categories in which 23 indicators of this index have been categorized. Remember the number of indicators as well as these 3 categories. Now moving ahead with this index, we have the top 10 countries and the bottom 10 countries with their scores. Now you would be thinking that will we have to remember the scores of these many countries also? So my answer here is no, guys, you don't have to remember the scores of all these countries. If maximum, you need to remember the score of Iceland, because it has achieved this perfect score of 1.1, and India's score. Okay, so the first country here is Iceland, the country that has topped this index, and the country which is at the bottom is Afghanistan. If we talk about the South Asian region, so in the South Asian region only, so this table is particularly for the South Asian region, measuring the peace in the South Asian region. So here Bhutan is at the first rank and India is at the 5th rank. Now you don't have to memorize all the rankings of all the countries, particularly this score table, and this is something that you can completely ignore. Okay, not in context of India. Okay, don't ignore it in the context of India. But yes, you can ignore it in terms of other countries. Just remember, Bhutan is the country in the South Asian region that is the most peaceful at present. Now here we have some additional facts from this report. The additional fact, the first fact here is that average global peacefulness has declined by 0.07%. Middle East and North African region is the least peaceful region, whereas Europe is the most peaceful region. So that is the basic fact. We all know about the regions, how these regions are always in the conflict, and which region enjoys the prosperity. Next comes the peacefulness that has improved in 87 countries, but it has deteriorated in 73 countries. The global economic impact of violence was 14.96 trillion in terms of purchasing power parity in 2020, and this data is equivalent to 11.6% of global GDP. So basically, due to the violence, this much purchasing power parity has been declined, has been lost due to the violence in the globe in 2020. And this amount, particularly US dollar 14.96 trillion, is equivalent to 11.6% of the global GDP. And if you were to divide this 11.6% of global GDP into per capita terms, per person terms, then it would be $1,942 per person. So per person has lost $1,942 worth of purchasing power parity due to the violence in 2020. So that is the meaning of this point. The next is the global economic impact of violence worsened for the second year in a row The global economic impact has increased by 0.2% or 32 billion from 2019 to 2020. So guys, this is the increase between 2019 to 2020, and here we are talking about the absolute impact that occurred in 2020. However, it is still $535.9 billion lower than the 2007 economic impact. So I hope that this much is clear to you. If you have any query and in understanding anything, you can ask me in the comment section or on the Telegram group anytime, guys. So I hope that these two points are clear, because these two points seem to be very difficult, but they are not actually very difficult. So that was all about this global peace index. Now let us discuss our second question. What is India's score in Sustainable Development Report 2021 of Sustainable Development Solutions Network? So here we have been given different scores, out of which India's score is 60.1 and the rank of India is 120. Now guys, you must have heard about Niti Aayog's Sustainable Development Index, SDG India Index. On this index, a special session was taken by Manish sir recently, so you can go and watch that session thoroughly to cover this 2021 SDG India Index. Now, as far as the Sustainable Development Report 2021 by the Sustainable Development Solutions Network is concerned, so let us discuss the details about this report here only. So this report was released by this network in partnership with Cambridge University Press. And the title of this report is Sustainable Development Report 2021, the Decade of Action for the Sustainable Development Goals. So this is the Decade of Action for the SDG was announced by United Nations. So you must have known about this earlier also. The next point here is that the report also includes SDG Index and SDG Dashboard. How much progress has been made towards achieving the Sustainable Development Goals? That is something that has been provided in this report. Total 193 UN members were ranked in this report, and top performance are right in front of you. So we have Finland at the first rank, which achieved the score of 85.9. Here, Sweden, Denmark, Germany, Belgium, Austria, Norway, France, Slovenia, Estonia are the other countries that are following Finland. Now here, you don't have to remember all these countries, just remember the top three countries, Finland, Sweden and Denmark. That will do for your preparations for upcoming examinations. The next point here is India's rank, 120th with the score of 60.1. We have already discussed it. Parameters, 17 sustainable development goals, 19 global indicators, as well as 30 additional indicators for OECD countries were also there in the SDG. So basically, sustainable development goals have been divided into different indicators in order to assess the countries. The bottom performers are these countries. So here you can remember Central African Republic is at the bottom. And you don't have to remember all these countries. This is just for your information. The next slide is about the additional facts that this Sustainable Development Report has provided. So here the first fact is all the countries have shown reversal in progress towards achieving the SDGs for the first time since 2015 due to the COVID-19 pandemic. So this is a very obvious point. COVID-19 pandemic has impacted many, many countries. The next point here is, before the pandemic hit, significant progress had been achieved on the SDGs in many regions and on many goals, especially in East and South Asia, which has progressed more on the SDG index than any other region since the goals adoption in 2015. So this is a very, I would say, irrelevant point, because there cannot be a question on this particular point in your phase one examination of RBI Sevinabad or the your banking PO examination. So this is just for your information purpose that East and South Asian region achieved more progress than any other region in terms of SDG achievement since the year 2015. The next point here is that the at the national level, Bangladesh, this got a award, and Afghanistan, so this is a South African country, this is an African country, and Afghanistan have improved most on the SDG index since 2015. So that was all about the Sustainable Development Report. Guys, do not forget to cover the NITI Aayog's SDG India index. Okay. Here comes our next question. Who has won the UN Land for Life Award 2021? So let me tell you guys that this award is the prestigious award in the field of land restoration and conservation given by the United Nations. So we have five options right in front of you, and out of these five options, Shyam Sundar Gyani is the right answer. He is the climate activist from Rajasthan, and he has been awarded this award for his concept of familial forestry. Now, what is the meaning of familial forestry? Familial is something that is related to family. So familial, under this familial forestry initiative, this Shyam Sundar Gyani has spread the awareness among the citizens of Rajasthan, particularly catering to women, that they should treat trees as part of their family. And by treating the trees as part of their family, the burden of caring for the trees also lies on the other family members. Therefore, this familial forestry concept is to increase the afforestation in the state of Rajasthan by including the other citizens of the state. So on the World Day to Combat Desertification and Drought, many women, approximately 100 women from 33 village panchayats, came forward and they planted approximately 5100 plant saplings in the state, just to observe that day under this familial forestry concept. So that is the news that is important for you to remember. This news that UN Land for Life Award for this year has been given to Shyam Sundar. Moving ahead to the next question, which state has launched the e-Pathshala and e-Mulyankan facilities for school students? The people who don't know Hindi very clearly, so let me tell you that e-Pathshala, Pathshala is for school, and Mulyankan particularly is for evaluation. Okay. So here we have Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Kerala in the options, out of which Odisha is the right answer. So through this e-Pathshala, online content will be provided to the students of school. And through this e-Mulyankan facility platform, or the test papers or examinations will be conducted for the school students. So that is the whole purpose of launching these two facilities, which is very obvious from their name itself. Apart from this, you should also know this fact that YouTube live streaming of the classes is also done by the school teachers in the state of Odisha. So that was all about this question. Now let's move on to the last question of the day. Who among the following has become the youngest player to win US Women's Open 2021 golf tournament? So out of these many options, the right answer is option A, Yoka Saso, and she is a basically Philippine Japanese person. So her nationality is Filipino Japanese. So that was all about this question and about this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.